It turns out there's a lot of things you can't learn from books or lecture halls that you really need to experience. You need to see visualizations or simulations or embodied activities are all ways to kind of get at that higher level thinking. So at its simplest, embodiment is really that we learn best through gesture or through movement. If we align sort of what we know about high quality teaching and learning with children's play, that's sort of what has inspired us in BioSim. We've designed a set of custom electronic puppets that the kids get to wear and be the bees. So there's a set of electronics that are embedded in there that give kids feedback. So that they go up to a flower, it'll tell them how much nectar and what the quality is through a set of LEDs on the head. It'll also tell them how much energy they have. Through this, they start to understand how a system is enacted, not just reading about these kinds of things.
Awesome. Do your dance.
The kids have to come back and then communicate with their peers, and they'll do a waggle dance. They're not allowed to talk. And so they sort of start to understand and empathize with the bee in that journey. We were funded a while back through the National Science Foundation, together with my colleague, Dr. Joshua Danish, who's at Indiana University, and another colleague from biology, Dr. Armin Mocek. And the three of us really set out to design a new system that would be fairly holistic for kids, that would be playful introduction of science, and give kids some really, all of the things that we want kids to know in college level biology at young ages. We've been running a series of experiments to understand, what role does that first person perspective of actually being the bee play on science learning, as opposed to watching the bee and sort of a third person perspective. And so our studies are teasing that apart. We're also teasing apart, how can I introduce a bee, not to say that you understand bees, it's not bees for bees' sake, but how can you understand the complex systems that bees are at play, so you can understand other complex systems in the world around you. There's lots of things kind of in our everyday world around us that can be a really playful invitation to understanding science. And so just really looking for those kinds of opportunities for young children is really important.